Hi everyone! In this video, I will show you how to create pure CSS morphing effect with clip path and 3D menu with perspective and preserve 3D CSS properties. We will draw a seahorse with clip path and it will be pointing its tail to the currently selected menu item. We will use a relatively unknown adjacent sibling selector, so whenever we hover a button, we can also animate the seahorse. I have made a similar video with animated fox before, but some people asked me to give commentary and explain how the code works, so here we go. Also, don't forget to like the video if you like it, subscribe to the channel, and click the bell icon to get notified when I release a new video. In index.html, we link style CSS file and create div with a class of container. Inside, we create three children divs. All three will have a shared class I called side. And I will separate them with additional classes side front, side left, and side top. Inside side front div, we will create four buttons with paragraph tag inside for home, about, contact, and shop. And finally, we create another div with a class of shape. Later, we will use clip path to cut out a seahorse out of it. In style CSS, we declare basic reset rules so we don't get any unexpected sizing issues in different browsers. We set container width and height to 200 pixels and perspective to 700 pixels. Perspective property defines how far away the object is from the user. The smaller the number, the more pronounced and warped 3D effect you will get. Now we will basically build a 3D cube. We will need only three sides as that's all we can see. We have our div with a class of box. We set its width and height to 100% of its parent. Transform style preserve 3D indicates that its children will be set in 3D space. Normally, if we rotate an element, it will stay in front of elements behind it at all times, but with preserve 3D property, these elements will clip through each other if their 3D spaces intersect. We will use transform property and rotate the element minus 20 degrees around the x-axis and plus 30 degrees around the y-axis. I am giving it blue background just to show you what's happening. This element will have no color. Inside, we have three sibling elements with a class of side. First, we will set styles for all three of them. Position absolute, width and height of 200 pixels, and a background color. Side front element will have transform translate Z 100 pixels, which will bring it closer to the viewer along the Z-axis in 3D space. Then we rotate side left minus 90 degrees along the y-axis and translate Z 100 pixels. And with side top, we rotate X 90 degrees and translate Z 100 pixels. Notice I also use the trick where we give each side slightly different shade of the same color to create illusion of 3D shadow. If you want to see another way to create and use 3D cube for your website, check out this video. We use HTML5 button tag, which comes with a lot of predefined CSS styles. First, I will reset everything to plain text. Then I will give it width 100%, font family impact, sized 40 pixels, transition 0.5 seconds, text align left, and padding left 20 pixels. When we hover the button, we will increase its padding left to 210 pixels. Now, we style the div with a class of shape we created earlier. First, we give it width and height of 400 pixels, and position it slightly to the left of the cube. Also, we give it black background color. Then, we go to this website to create a custom clip path. Default clip path has only 3 points or 4 points, so we delete it and use this polygonal lasso tool to create our custom one. The way it works is you create your own shape, and once you close that shape, you will scroll down and see clip path CSS code. It will also generate SVG, but we will not be using that in this video. I'm not gonna show you the entire process of me drawing the seahorse here. I will include the link for the website and the code for the seahorse in the description down below. I will also include the code pen with the complete project, so you can play with it if you want. We copy the clip path values and paste it onto our shape element. Since this element is a sibling of button element, we can use adjacent sibling selector, little squiggly line, to change its CSS whenever we hover on the button. This is how we create hover effects on siblings. We go back to the website, slightly change the clip path while making sure the new shape has the same amount of points and the paths don't cross too much, as we want to avoid glitches and we want to create an illusion of movement. Before we do that, we can also create a simple keyframes effect where we animate the seahorse up and down along the y-axis and rotate it slightly. We add animation I called float. It will loop every 10 seconds infinitely. Now our seahorse is slowly floating up and down. So finally, we just paste the custom clip paths I created earlier, and we're done. While you're here, you can also check out my other clip path videos. For example, do you know how to create a menu like this? Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to like the video if you liked it, subscribe to the channel, and click the bell icon so you get notified when I release a new video. See you next time.